Penguin Random House Audio presents The Penguin Book of Outer Space Exploration, NASA and the Incredible Story of Human Spaceflight. Edited by John Logsdon. Foreword by Bill Nye. Read for you by Jonathan Davis. With an introduction written and read by John Logsdon. Foreword by Bill Nye. There have been hundreds of thousands of documents written for and about the U.S. space program, literally tons. They tell a story shaped not only by domestic politics and international political and military conflict, but also by the strange desire deep within us to do and achieve something greater than ourselves, to glean something of the grand mystery of creation. That story is all here, in more than 100 documents that shaped space history. With these few small steps, humankind became a spacefaring species. Many more steps are to come. It might seem obvious looking back, but when spaceflight began, it wasn't clear which team, by that I mean which space program, sponsored by which government and which country, would make it to the moon first. And it certainly wasn't obvious how profoundly the world would be changed by humanity's ventures into space. In this audiobook, John Logsdon uses the original source materials to take us on a journey from the shores of Florida to the farthest reaches of the cosmos. Did you know that prior to Yuri Gagarin's flight, there were fears that a human simply could not survive being launched into space? Did you know the first guys to walk on the moon filled out customs forms? After all, they had been out of the country for a few days. Did you know that President Nixon used the shuttle program to ensure votes for his re-election? Did you know that in 1993, it was Russian space leaders who suggested merging the U.S. and Russian space station programs? The evidence is here in these documents. The story of space exploration is marked by a series of turning points, a series of policy decisions. These decisions are documented well enough, but the key documents would be very hard to find if you didn't know where to look. Dr. Logsdon does. He's the Dean of Space History. He's the world's foremost authority on which of the hundreds of thousands of documents hold the keys to knowing what and why significant things happened on Earth that influenced our presence in space. For many of us, the most significant event in the history of space exploration to date remains the first human landing on the moon, which Neil Armstrong called one small step for a man, one giant leap for mankind. But in my view, there is little doubt that the next grand achievement in space will render the moon landings both a giant leap for their time, but a small step toward the future. The documents included here show that once the Soviet Union had sent its robotic emissary, the first Sputnik satellite, to the ultimate high ground of space, the world changed. Humans vied for access to and control over what would be a limitless frontier. The United States created the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, NASA, and the space race was born. From the beginning, there was conflict and tension between those in presidential administrations who wanted to achieve strategic or geopolitical objectives in space, and those who wanted to explore space for the sake of science. As today's commercial space companies grow, this tension will manifest itself in new ways. Here's hoping these documents will help us find the best course forward. At the height of the competition to get to the moon, NASA's budget was 10 times what it is today. It led to the return of the famed moon rocks, which solidified our understanding of the age of the moon, the age of the Earth, and the moon's origin. The astronauts' gloves on exploration, along with all sorts of other geologic evidence, led researchers to conclude that the moon is made of a large ball of Earth, from the planet Earth. Our moon is made of once molten Earth's crust. It is a profound insight. it gets at an answer to the age-old question, where did we all come from? However, for me, it frankly pales compared with a single photograph that was taken before anyone set moon boot on the lunar surface. That Apollo 8 image has come to be called the Earthrise photo. That image changed the way everyone on Earth viewed our place in the blackness of space. Documents included here show how the decision to send Apollo 8 to the moon was made. But did we need a human explorer, who wasn't even a professional photographer, to take that picture? Did we really need to send people there to collect rocks? The Soviet program did the same things with a series of robotic explorers. While the Soviet missions to the moon are seldom remembered, the 12 Americans who walked on the lunar surface deserve their place in human history. As one 1961 document included here says, it is man, not merely machines, in space that captures the imagination of the world. On the other hand, our cosmic view has been enhanced immeasurably by the amazing images taken by robotic spacecraft silently hurtling through the cold dark and from above and upon the surfaces of other worlds. But what will our view of the cosmos be like after human explorers have set boots on the soil of Mars? Will we remember the noble robot sent before? Listen and judge for yourself. After great achievements on the moon, the U.S. space program was pulled back. Rather than driving farther and deeper into space, the program and its mission were redirected to more earthly pursuits, or more accurately, more just above the Earth's atmosphere pursuits. The shuttle program kept thousands of space professionals engaged and created a fleet of spaceships that proved to be expensive and hard to operate safely. While hundreds of astronauts traveled through the hard vacuum of low Earth orbit, not much new was accomplished scientifically, with the important exception of the Hubble Space Telescope, which is still in service as I write. Hubble has helped us understand the origin of the universe, the Big Bang, the objects beyond Neptune and Pluto. It has given us thousands of images that are easily recognized by humans the world around. Hubble was launched with a flawed mirror, and only because it was designed to be serviced by astronauts was it able to deliver on its promise. Some question what the United States and other nations would have achieved if the same resources directed toward competition in space had instead been brought to bear on technical problems down here on Earth. I believe if you study the history presented here, you'll see it's not a fair question. The records show that NASA was created to compete, and the competition of the Cold War led to extraordinary technologies. We have handheld devices that provide five or more independent systems of communication, remarkably accurate navigation, and endlessly varied software applications that can notify us of emergencies, track our health, and entertain us. It's all been brought down to Earth from space. It may surprise you to read that in addition to science, the shuttle program and the International Space Station have contributed a great deal to diplomacy. In their native countries, there are no bigger heroes than the astronauts, from Canada, Italy, Japan, Sweden, and the United Kingdom, among many other countries, who've flown a few hundred nautical miles straight up from home. The legacy of this part of the U.S. space program is more political than technical, but nonetheless, very real and extremely significant. Not long before NASA was redirected to fly primarily in low Earth orbit, other workers in the agency and the scientific community wanted to see what was out there, farther from home, and far more difficult to explore. There was, in the 1960s, a concurrent push for exploring Mars. The first Mars probe was a repurposed and modified version of the Ranger spacecraft that had been designed and flown to the moon. By flown to the moon, we mean purposefully smash-landed on the moon. As Mariner 4, the same design sent us the first pictures of another world. This led scientists and engineers to propose and succeed in flying two spacecraft that soft-landed on Mars. The first pictures went around the world at the speed of light. For the first time, humankind saw that our planet had a neighbor, a kindred world with a rocky surface that looks not altogether different from areas here on our home world.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.